Yeah, welcome back, Wing Games 2019. Congratulations to all the four-way teams we've just seen. Coming up next, Emma Maticola and me will be bringing you the quarterfinals of Dynamic Two-Way.
Every day, we are learning more about our evolving world. Every day, ideas are born. Challenges become opportunities. To succeed, we need people with the vision, passion, and the knowledge to turn opportunity into reality. That's us at ABB. Thinkers, engineers, scientists, innovators. The ideal partners to unlock customer value through the domain expertise of a digital pioneer. We have the strength to realize the once unthinkable. Writing a future where cities are free from traffic emissions. Where buildings produce more energy than they consume. And renewable energy knows no borders. Traveling across countries and continents. A future where machines can tell us how they feel, where ships with sensors communicate to navigate more efficiently. A future where robots work hand in hand with humans. We are driving the progress our world needs and creating value for our customers with smarter, faster, more reliable solutions. And joining forces with Formula E is a major part of our mission to make the electric revolution come true. Day after day, we bring visions to life. Let's write the future together. ABB.
Hi, welcome back, guys. It's Wing Games 2019 here in Pura Brava, Spain. Emma Maticola, me, Regan Tetlow, bringing you the quarterfinals of the two-way dynamics. We've got eight teams left. It's into the knockouts. Emma, what's happening?
Well, it's going to be very exciting now. We're going to see some battles. This is the quarterfinals. So first up, we are going to see Windor Blades take on Windor Ninjas in a speed round, then free round. If the results, if one team wins one team wins the other, we will go to a tie-break situation. But right now, we can see the Windor Blades in the tunnel getting ready. Matteo and Elliot.
Yeah, the Ninjas are ready to go. These two French flyers based here on Pura Brava, Windor Ninjas with their speed round. Let's make sure we get the timer on the screen. We need the clock to see it as it starts, and then we know what's going on with the speeds, and it's the fastest team through. Here we go, Emma. 3, 2, 1, bam, they're in.
Yes, they are. So this team finished in third position yesterday. They are in, looking very nice for the butterfly. In two mixed circles. And beginning their page again, head down, in face snake. Butterfly.
Just watching the action where we are on the clock. 41 seconds currently, 42 seconds speed round. And then we're going to see the we're going to see both speed rounds first and then both three rounds after that.
Yes, we are. This is looking good. This is looking fast, Regan. This is going to be setting the benchmark for the time.
Come on. Here we go, first time on the clock, about to come out the door. And we have Emma, 62.855.
Laying down the challenge now for the Windor Blades.
I seem to write a lot of numbers down there, Emma. I don't know what I was doing.
It is. Regan's writing a lot of extra numbers, but that's okay.
62.855.
Yes, looking very nice, boys. So just to remind you of the draw, it is head down in face snake, followed by butterfly, followed by mixed circles.
We've got some good battles here. Just looking at the who's battling each other. It's going to be good stuff. And we're bang on. We're right into it now. The blades are in.
Yes, they are. Butterfly. Into mixed circles.
Look how fast it is, Emma.
It is incredibly fast. This team were one of the lower positioning teams yesterday. They finished in fifth place, whereas the Windor Ninjas finished in third place. So we would say that the Windor Ninjas had an advantage going into this, but anything can happen.
62.8 is the time to beat. We got a little tease of a very nice graphic on the left-hand side of the screen a moment ago. It's going to be interesting to see what that is and how that works. We're looking forward to that.
Yes, it is. So far, oh no, we've had one bust by the blades. That is going to incur a 5-second penalty for each of those two busts now. The red lights are not what we want to see. They're out.
And finishing with a time of 71.427. So first blood going to the Ninjas.
First blood, Regan. You're making it sound very dramatic.
Oh, that's my job, love.
It is dramatic, though. So, Regan, what was the sort of outcome of that then?
Well, look at the times. If it wasn't for those two penalties, that would have been a 61.4 versus Ninja 62.8. So very evenly matched, but those 5-second penalties, they've hurt them hard.
Yes, they have. So judges look like they are just looking at something now, just reviewing something on their screens, possibly a challenge for the bust.
And each round, we've got the speed round and the free round. And so we will be going into the free round next.
We certainly will, Regan. So we can see you did just have a cut of the tunnel. The teams in the chamber were reviewing the footage. They were seeing what they could see. There we go. That's a nice view of the teams reviewing their footage now. They can now choose whether they want to challenge that bust or not. So when I'm saying bust, I mean a penalty incur of 5 seconds.
Yeah, so what's body language is smiles, pats on the shoulder.
Yep, so we are just waiting to see what has been decided. So we can see the teams watching. This is a fantastic insight into what happens backstage. This is not something we usually are able to see.
And that's a theme of the day as well. In a four-way now, we've had the live judging, looking at the judges in the judges' room, what's going on. And now we are here watching the judges as well, Emma. It's all backstage action.
Yes, it is. It looks like the Windor Ninjas are going to do their free routine. It is not looking as though the Blades are going to challenge either of their busts. Which means next up is going to be the Windor Ninjas. We're going to see that fantastic routine again.
So after these two free rounds, that means we've got all things done. The two speeds, the two frees, we get them back in the tunnel. We get the Wind Girls in there, and it's arms up for the champions.
Yes, it is. We've got the Wind Girls in their amazing blue suits with their amazing blue makeup. We've got a very, very young Wind Girl with us today, haven't we?
Apparently, when they first arrived and they were walking around in the suits with the makeup, somebody here actually thought they were one of the teams.
Oh, who could that be, Regan Tetlow?
I don't know. Anyway, we're going to come to the studio and have a little chat with Emma Matacola, because we've not seen you all day, Emma. Well, were you in the studio this morning a little bit?
I was. I was here at about 9:15, 9:30. We did the freestyle.
Yeah. Open and junior.
For compulsories.
Yes, we did indeed. We've got another round of that coming up. We've got the free rounds coming up as well.
We've
got the solo speed to finish off.
We've got the relay races.
We've got everything to finish off. It's just a jam-packed day.
So much to do. Four speed. My goodness, there's everything, Regan. We are going to be exhausted by the end of the day, but it's so worth it.
And then the awards ceremony.
There's so much to look forward to.
So I'm trying to remember the ninjas soundtrack for their free round. Can you remember which one it was?
Was it Jump Around?
It was.
It was Jump Around. That one got the crowd going. Spoke to Elliot last night. He was much happier with the way the free routine went last night as opposed to the first time they performed it where they missed foot knocking cartwheel. This incredible move that they do that is coming up soon. You are going to see it. You are going to love it. If you didn't see it yesterday, you've missed a treat, so you need to stay tuned.
Settle down, put your feet up, put the kettle on, order 15 pizzas, because you're going nowhere for the rest of the day. Listen, Emma, last night what we saw with the free rounds were absolutely incredible. It was quite emotional, wasn't it?
It really was. I think we did get emotional at several different points.
There was
we?
One point that came back to the studio, and we're like, no, no, we're going to cry.
Regan was just about holding it together.
Just about holding it. It's very emotional experience to be here. This Wynn Games, this sixth edition here, 2019, is really just showcasing so much new stuff. The live judging, the indicative scoring on the four ways, the behind the scenes, looking at the judges in the four way. But what we've been doing all week as well is looking over the shoulders of the judges as they're deliberating.
That has been a really, really nice change, actually, Regan. Something really, really good to see. It just goes to show, you know, Windsor keep pushing this sport forward. The competitions keep evolving. Every competition brings something new, something exciting.
Yeah, well, we're going to go down to the action and look at the free round from the Window Ninjas.
This is exciting. Elliot's got a little smile on his face. He knows this free routine is good. So watch out for one of the team will knock the other's feet, sending him into a cartwheel. It is quite something to watch.
Don't
Come
forget
on.
The music, DJ. Let's get the music up. Let's make sure we get the music on.
Elliot Pote and Matteo Limnaeus, both from France. This is the Windsor Ninjas about to do their free routine in their battle against the Windsor Blades. This is very, very exciting, Regan. Can see Roy Wimmer-Jaglam sitting by the side with his camera, official photographer for the Wynn Games 2019. If you haven't seen Roy's photos yet.
We need to get him in the studio.
Maybe we should get him in the studio. We need Roy Wimmer-Jaglam in this studio now, don't we, Regan?
Well, he's got to photograph this lot first. Elliot. He always does this, Elliot. He hides his nerves. With a little bit of a showmanship, doesn't he?
Almost sort of a little smile, smirk kind of thing. And then he just pulls it out of the bag and you just would never know he was nervous.
Here we go, game on, Windsor Ninjas.
Windsor Ninjas.
All right, Emma, what do you think?
That was incredible.
All right, so we've had the speed rounds. Waiting for the free round from Windsor Blades. Shall we check in with the audience? Good afternoon, Windsor. All right, so let's do that again. Good morning, Windsor. How are we all doing, okay? Are you okay? Are you good? Are you good, driver? Are you happy? Everybody's happy around here? Bar staff are happy? Yeah, Blades are ready! Blades are ready! Oh, wow. Long days, eh? Long days, ladies and gentlemen. Emma, it's a great atmosphere down here. There seems to be a lot of gold tape around. A lot of gold confetti, Emma.
What could that gold tape be from, Regan, I wonder?
Oh, wow. It's busy out there.
It looks busy. It looks like you had to fight your way through that crowd.
Just checking the live screen. on my system. Seems to have changed videos.
Regan's now got a video called Grumpy Cats.
I wonder what you're going to say then.
So,
blades, we know blades. Come on. Game on. Oh, Emirates window against window.
It is. That was very, very exciting. Blades against ninjas.
Right. I think we've got a challenger, have we, Emma?
I think we have. I think we are about to see something quite new that we've not seen before. Something else new that we've not seen before, Regan. So earlier I was told about the competitors being able to show a red card if they want to challenge a bus.
But this is on the free round, so how could they be challenging?
Yeah, I think it must be previous. It must be going on to the speed rounds, as there obviously will not be a challenge on the free rounds. So we will just see what is happening.
All right, so can you just tell me a little bit more about that then, please, Emma?
About the challenge?
Yeah.
So what I was told earlier is if a team would like to challenge a bust that has been given during the speed round, they will take a red card. Which will be up in the chamber wall. They will be able to enter the tunnel with the red card, show the card to the judges, signifying that they want to challenge the bust. The judges will then review that, but it will make it a lot clearer for the audience, for the people watching at home. Everybody will know more clearly what is going on.
So we're into the final eight. It's the top versus the bottom. That's what we're looking for
not
to move forward.
Top versus bottom. We will see one and eight a bit later on.
Yeah.
iFlight Aspire and a Jochen Schweizer.
We're
Arena.
Looking at the bottom of the rankings right now.
Now we are looking at with Windor Blades and Windor Ninjas. Yesterday they battled and ranked in position one down to position eight.
Yes.
Now Windor Ninjas finished in third.
Uh-huh.
And Blades in fifth.
So that's the battle we're watching right now. And this is going to determine when the winner moves forward.
So the winner of this battle is going to be battling the winner.
Well, you just find that. I'm just watching the judges here. Cathy throws her arms in the air. I was asking Cathy Boulay yesterday, I said, when we're talking like this and mentioning your name while you're doing your job and the camera's over your shoulder, does it disturb you? She said, no, it's okay. But then
I did notice she had earplugs in though.
Really. Ah, right.
Yeah. Probably to block us out.
Yeah, not the first girl who's done that to me, to be honest. So Elliot is now looking around. Just wondering how he is moving forward. So the winner, did we find out who they will battle?
So we know that the team that does not win this battle will then be going to battle the one who does not win in the quarterfinal four, round four.
I will tell
you who that will be. That will be Jochen Schweizer Arena Airfoils and iFly Aspire. So either Windor Blades or Windor Ninjas will battle Jochen Schweizer Arena Airfoils or iFlight Aspire.
So in this section, we're going to find out who finishes in the bottom half of them, us eight teams. And then this after, when we get into the finals, we'll see who's at the top positions.
Exactly. So essentially, we're going to see all eight teams fly. There will be four winners and four losers.
Yes. And those four winners will be in the semi-final.
Yep. And the four losers will battle it out to find their final position.
Yes. If you've been joining us for the last couple of days, we're really happy to have you along. It's the third and final day of action. Finished off already the VFS, the Open FS, and the Female FS is all done. Their positions are done. They're all that remains to be done for them now is the medal ceremony this evening.
Yeah, it looked like a very exciting morning, Regan.
Yeah, absolutely was, with so much new stuff being showcased. And I can tell you now, the Facebook Live has just been restarted. So if you want to activate that on your systems, if anybody's watching on the web pages and wants to watch it on Facebook Live.
Brilliant. I can see Jerem is watching.
Emma Maticola has just joined us.
Marieva Sander is here. Rosie Manning, hello. We've had so much support here on the live stream, haven't we, Regan?
Yeah, we have. We're going to be getting great comments coming through. The sport has changed a lot over the last few years, but we're getting the teams into the tunnel now, Emma, for the result. So will we have two raises or just one raise for everything?
We should have two raises.
One for the speed round?
Yeah.
So the winner of the speed round that we have it is the Ninjas. So let's see if that happens.
So we are assuming that the Wind Girls' right hand will be raised, lifting up the hands of the Ninjas.
That's on the left of your screen. Should be two awards now, one for the speed round, one for the free round.
Some nervous looks there in the tunnel. Elliot is smiling. I think he kind of has an inkling that he has beaten the Windor Blades on the speed round.
He was very confident about his speed before this event. He was talking to me outside the tunnel, talking about just how fast these guys were flying. And you can see on his face, he's just watching. Just as we've got it down, it looks like the Blades had two busts, which would give him a 71.4. And the Ninjas with Elliot there with a 62.8 clean. So if the judges have decided to do something about these penalties, it's going to switch it up. If those penalties don't, both of them are lost, the Blades will be the fastest team member.
Yes, they will. Nervously waiting for the results here. This is getting very, very exciting. Which hand will go up? The Wind Girl will raise their Wind or Ninja's hand.
So they take the speed round. One blow to the Blades. And the second goes to the Ninjas. Emma moving forward.
Ninjas take this. Ninjas have beaten the Blades. There is no need for a tiebreak now. This is great news for Wind or Ninjas. Perhaps not too much of a surprise for the Blades, although there is always a chance, but that speed round was significantly faster from the Windor Ninjas.
So we've got our first result in the two-way dynamic quarterfinals, and the Windor Ninjas take it. We'll be back in a couple of moments.